This is an AI clone, not just of my face and voice, of my thoughts as well, trained on my public profile.
Hello, Joe. What is it that Joe Tidy likes to do for fun?
I enjoy participating in triathlons, marathons, and wild swimming. I also like golfing and am a movie geek.
Aside from the long delays, it works pretty well, one-to-one. What if I send it to a work meeting?
These AI clones are more about attending meetings than doing the whole job. Keeps things interesting, though.
Before we try that, it needs a few tweaks with these engineers, who are experts in making bespoke chatbots. There's growing excitement for AI clones across the industry. The CEO of Zoom says in the future, we'll be able to offload some of our more mundane meetings to the bots. It sounds bonkers, but things are moving fast.
With AI services, you don't need any technical skill.
These days you can make a video of anybody saying anything in any language quite easily.
But putting an avatar into a live meeting, that looks like and sounds like someone is far more complex.
Police in Hong Kong are investigating just that possibility after an employee from a British construction firm, Arup, was tricked during a video call in February. Criminals operating an AI clone of his boss successfully persuaded him to transfer more than $25 million in a fake deal. It's thought to be the first case of so-called CEO fraud being done with an AI clone during a video call. This type of crime has historically been done through emails. But with AI, criminals have far more tools to play with.
Martin, upon signing the NDI, I will be able to furnish you with additional details to ensure the successful completion of this operation.
Yeah, I mean, they were quite lifelike. And actually, later on in the process, when I actually forwarded these to someone who's known him for years, he actually said, OK, well, that actually could be Marco.
Martin was targeted by criminals who sent him voice notes that sounded like his new boss and almost convinced him into transferring £800,000 to them.
So presumably the criminals would have taken maybe even that video, put it through a machine, then made your bespoke voice notes.
Absolutely. And you need a few seconds, apparently, of speech to work with, and they pick up the mannerisms, they pick up the kind of way in the language and the way it's used, and actually quite believable, really.
Martin only spotted the scam after triple-checking an email address used by the scammers pretending to be a lawyer. AI voice cloning attacks are becoming more common, but pulling off a convincing live video call with face and voice cloning that can be controlled by scammers is thought to be much harder.
Then again, saying you've got bad signal can cover up many flaws.
Hi, team.
But what about sending a full AI clone to a meeting on your behalf then for non-criminal purposes? This is the weekly tech news planning meeting.
Hey, how's it going?
Good, thank you.
Oh, it is AI, isn't it?
It's AI. It's definitely AI. I said it was AI to start with. The blinking was so weird.
Interestingly, though, some were more unsure than others.
Graham, Lily, were you on it as quickly as Liv and Tom were?
No, I was not. But also I'm on my phone, and so it's smaller than it would be if I had it up on my computer.
For me, Joe just looks really, really unwell, and I just didn't want to be impolite.
This AI clone then was fooling no one, but its creator says there's definite potential.
There are differences in expectations. If I'm telling you I have created a digital twin, it acts exactly like me, you would pretty soon tell me that no, this is not you. On the other hand, if I say, hey, I have an assistant, it's an AI, you'd have a completely different set of expectations. This face swapping technology does cost a lot of money to do right, but again, everything gets cheaper and it happens so fast.
All the perils and positives of AI clones are coming at us fast. Clearly, we're going to have to start working a lot harder to make sure we know who's on the other side of that screen.
How can I assist you?
Joe Tidy, BBC News.